Hi, welcome to the show.
Hello.
How are you?
What's that there? That's strange, isn't it?
It's sparkling.
Ah, it's a light, Chris. That's what it is. It's aliens. Sorry about that. Anyway, hello, welcome to the show. Technical difficulties.
Yeah.
We're starting with a lovely new piece of jazz.
We are indeed. I love this. Yeah, and it's on Village Live Records, and it's this cute little chap here, obviously when he was younger. Doron Sigal from Israel, I believe. And we have got the press release here from lovely dude at Village Live. And they're proud to present their latest release, Doron Sigal, The Edition of Strangeness. He's an Israeli jazz pianist and composer based in Berlin. His debut album sees him exploring the contemporary jazz genre with a smooth, innovative and modern approach. And it is awesome. And it's out...
Last Friday.
So there you go. Buy this. It's killer. It's really nice.
It is nice.
Very nice.
Yeah. Anyway.
Weird bit of a quiff going on here, Brad.
Yeah, we got quite a few libraries this week. I rushed here from the office, so Chris had to dig in the vaults and libraries, but actually it's quite apt.
They're all pretty new though. I mean, I got a pile of libraries on Sunday, in a little tray, which was quite nice.
But not as new as the new Chris Reed release.
Which we'll be playing later on, which is killer. Very nice indeed.
It's nice, man.
It's lovely, yeah. All the way through.
Yeah,
very nice indeed. Anyway, next up, we're going to have to step up the pace a little bit. And I found this one, 50 pence. And I've got the other version, but this is a Trip to Your Mind by the Hudson People, and it's a different cut, slightly later than the original, but it's still such a great tune that we should play it. So here we go. Yeah, great bit of British jazz funk disco on Ensign Records, 1979. Hudson People, Trip to Your Mind. Love this track, very nice.
Yeah, there you go, 50p bargain.
50p, I was very happy with this actually, yeah.
Yeah.
I mean, I've already got it, but it's a slightly different sort of take on it, so I might keep it. And I think I might even prefer this version, because it's a little bit cleaner.
Yeah, it certainly does. Chris said earlier about keeping some stuff to do a Shed Beats 3, sorry. And you know what we should do? Even if we do it, it's just as a free release online, Chris. Over Sunday.
Yeah, totally.
Bring some stuff over Sunday. We'll do that. Bring some stuff over Sunday and we'll get ready for Andy's wedding.
Yes.
And we'll do that.
Yeah, good idea.
Let's do that.
Alright, cool.
Excited. Yeah.
Cool.
If you've never listened to Chef Beats 1 or Chef Beats 2, well, they're awesome. They are awesome.
They are.
Released on the wonderful
Mudge.
An eclectic mix of samples, loops, and
film skits.
It's brilliant. We got lots of good press over that.
Yeah.
Even from our mums.
Well, I like the skits probably more than anything else.
So do I. Yeah. I like the video that I made.
I can guarantee that when me and Brad go to the pub, all we talk about is films from the 80s.
And porno mates. No, we never talk about porno mates. But the we are literally like, it's like Last of the Mitref and Chris, it's like Last of the Summer Wine.
It is.
But talking about 80s movies.
That's right. And Trevor does actually still do his trousers up with string.
He does, it's true. Yeah. Trevor makes lists of movies because he hasn't seen them.
He does. Geek.
Yeah.
Anyway, cool. Next up, this is another one that I got from the wilds of Hemel Hempstead and Ray Barretto Live. And it's got a nice little break on it as well, so we'll probably, it's a bloody long track, so we'll probably just have to flick it through to the best bits.
Yes,
you will.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's nice, this.
Magic hands of Ray Barretto.
That's right, hard hands.
Hard hands, yeah.
Yeah.
So last week, if anyone watches, they'd have known that we're talking about, or was it? No, it was in the pub after the show, so we were talking about Steve Davis.
Oh, yeah!
So he liked our tweet, so I got excited. So I sent him a text back saying, we'll come to you, we'll bring Posh Crisps and beer. He hasn't replied.
No. You might have put him off.
Come on, Steve.
Come on, Steve, you can do it.
We know you watch every week, you're queuing out. Yeah, literally, he's a lovely guy anyway. It doesn't matter if he doesn't come on, I like, always like Steve Davis.
That's right. Just badger him, these people need to be badgered.
Sometimes
make feel
you
important.
Just need to badger people.
That's right.
You're absolutely right, mate. Badger, badger, badger.
That's right.
Yeah.
Should we find the brake on this? It's pretty good,
right? Find it.
Is it near here?
Maybe.
No. Still cool though.
We like this as well. Do you know Washington's playing at the Chapel Bar on the 2nd of March?
Is he really? He must be ancient.
Well, I was trying to work out his age because he was early 60s he started, didn't he? Mm. He was in the...
He was in the army, wasn't he?
He was in the US Air Force.
That's right, yeah, but based in...
Close over, when our mate John Schroeder, rest in peace, was over, he told us all about it, didn't he?
He did.
He said there were bands that didn't quite transfer from live to album from the studio.
Yeah, and I can...
It's called the Lightning, isn't it?
Yeah.
I get that. Sometimes the experience is better than the quality.
Yeah, and I think that happens to a fair few people as well. Some people are just recording artists, some people are live artists.
Yeah, that's it. Different thing.
Me and Brad are both.
Yes, we are. So if anyone's to sign us, here we are.
That's right.
This is lovely.
Yeah, anyway. It is nice. And there is a break somewhere. Hang on.
Find the break, Chris. If you're not sure what this album is, you're looking for your Robert Urban, look for the one where he looks like a nan. Sorry. There you go.
Yeah. B-boy.
Ooh.
Very nice. And yes, this is a roller coaster ride of emotions this week, so we're going to go right down again. But yeah, and as I said last week, I've been listening to a lot of Jazz FM, so I can't help but like these old jazz sort of classics, you know what I mean?
Don't need to do that. I'm having a fiddle through my head because you'll find loads of jazz.
I know, I do. But yeah, so next up, a little bit of Nancy Wilson, but it's nice, and her version on One Note Samba, which is lovely, so here we go. Yeah, I love every version of this actually, I think it's a really cool song. Even the Ugly Duckling version.
Today, tomorrow, forever.
50p in a charity shop.
There you go. You'll probably find it in loads of charity shops.
Yeah. You won't play that much of it. Just kind of dig it.
1964.
There you go. Because next time we'll funk it up a little bit now. I've got this at the weekend as well, it's quite nice. I've had a reissue of this, I think, so, but not the original. So Soul Train introducing the Rim Shots. So yeah, the Rim Shots, Soul Train. And I think we're going to go with Coasting and Crashing, Part 1.
Yeah, the Rim Shots. Chris used to be called Rim Shot when I was a kid. I think it's a wonder why.
Yeah, never missed.
Fucking
hell. Yeah, really good. Yeah, on all platinum records, A1 records, or AL records, or whatever. Which basically is Sugar Hill records. So there you go. But yeah, it's excellent. This is. And it was a freebie as well.
What?
A freebie, yeah.
Wow.
Chucked into my trade for nothing.
Zero.
I know. So yeah, very nice.
If you
want
to listen
to us, good because I ain't got any money.
If you want to listen to me and Chris, obviously at the private gig where next week you can't come to, you're coming already. But next month you will find me and Chris down in the Black Dove in Brighton at the wonderful Jazzology.
That's right.
Yes. That's where we'll be.
I'm really looking forward to collating a good little set there.
Fucking love that, mate.
Yeah, it was really cool.
Really looking forward to it. I love that. I think Justice and Metro played there of late, didn't they?
They have, yeah. Well, they've been playing everywhere.
They have.
Tony Justice is even out and about.
like he's young again.
It really is. He's dyed his grey hair.
So. He doesn't age though, in fairness.
No, he doesn't. Oh, no,
yeah, he's like Professor Brian Cox, or whatever. Yeah. Kind of justice.
That's right.
I've other gigs lined up I need to talk to you about, actually. So
it's always worth me knowing about them.
Well, I guess if I'm going to be there with you, mate, unless I'll be there without you, but I don't like to do that.
That's good.
Safety in numbers these days, Chris.
Oh, I know.
But yeah, so we'll keep you informed if you want to come and see us, have us, you know.
Cool.
Sign your face.
Tits, whatever.
Yeah. Cool, this is lovely. Moving on, KPM.
And then we're going to go back down again. But yeah, a little KPM here. And this is lovely, but it is quite melancholic. But it's Gentle Sounds, Volume 3. Subtle, lilting melodies, tender, wistful, sentimental, warm, feminine. That's right. James Clark, Stan Tracy even does a track on this, and David Lindup. But yeah, can't remember which one we're going to play, but we will find one.
Beautiful. Yeah, Gentle Sounds, Volume 3.
Mystic beauty. Rich, romantic, flutes featured.
Just in time for Valentine's.
Indeed.
Let it not be said that we're not romantic.
I still haven't got my wife a card yet, but we'll see.
What? My girlfriend's going away.
Oh, really?
Leaving me on my own.
Romantic night in by yourself, is it?
Going for a pint with my mate Will. Will, me and you.
Ah, there you go.
Yeah. And you don't go changing, Will. Valentine's this Thursday. I did buy some earrings, huh?
Cool.
Make sure you get your other half something lovely and special.
That's right, like a KPM record.
Exactly where I was going. Or if you wanted to, you could get them the next one, which is the Digging in the Broughton Bumps.
There we go.
Hot on the heels of, well, I say hot on the heels, of the other Digging in the Bumps that they did. Chris Reed has put together the old friends, Soundsci, and Mr. Thing, amongst others.
What do we play? Well, you know,
I know what I want to play.
Mr. Thing, I think, is going to get a play.
How about Mr. Thing?
So it was really nice of him to get me to do the scratching on his track.
I've worked with these things, he just knows Chris, doesn't he? You know? If Mr. Thing, if he's so good, if he was a politician, Brexit would be sorted.
It would.
Sorted. If he was in Star Wars, he'd only be in the original trilogy, and it'd be Han Solo.
That's right.
It's that good.
Yeah,
if
very nice.
If he was a lady, he'd be Ripley out of Aliens. That's good. So, yeah, cool.
Yeah, bro. Really cool. Yeah, so get one of these. I don't think there's many of them, so you better get one fairly sharpish. But yeah, really cool.
Yeah.
A great little thing to slip into your library collection.
It really is. I haven't got this one yet, I've got the others.
Others,
no, two, wasn't there? Yeah.
There's the Boozy and Hawks one.
Yeah, yeah.
And
is there a KPM one?
No, not yet.
No, there isn't. The Boozy and Hawks was the first one. You got them there? At hand.
There's the Boozy and Hawks one. But there was another one, which was a bigger one, wasn't there?
I'm sure there was, yeah. Anyway,
quick.
Get this.
Yeah.
Can't miss it. It's orange. Yeah, that's the thing. Sounds like on this as well, as we say.
Really good. And Chris Reed himself.
And Chris Reed himself, as well as many others. Danny Drythrough, Pugs of Toms, Big Kids,
Mark Ray,
and Satnasa.
There you go. And keeping with the library theme, our break of the week is also from a library, and I actually put it on Instagram the other week because it's a pretty cheap sort of library record. This is the one on the coast, Bruton. But if you play How's Tricks, lively bebop featuring electric guitar, there's a rather nice b-boy break on it. So here is our break of the week. Not the best song, to be fair, but the break is nice.
I quite like this song.
It's alright.
I like it.
I like
a bit of noodly guitar.
It's jaunty.
Yep. It certainly is. Don't forget to check out our man, Tough Cut. every Sunday, that's 4 right. till 6 on Itch FM, Quite Fast Show.
That's right. He takes requests.
He does take requests.
Yes.
He really does. It's true. Text him.
Yes.
Text him anything you like.
That's right.
He'll reply.
He will. Right.
Yeah.
I think I want to play the break.
Play the break.
Oh, no. It's all right.
I like
not
it.
Bad,
I'm telling you, I quite like it.
Play the break is. Hang on. Nice.
Yep.
Yes.
Anyway.
Which leads us nicely onto our theme of the week, which is Roy Budd. Yeah, got this at the Victoria Fair the other week, and it was half. Half mark price, which is why I bought it.
You got that off that jazz fair, didn't you?
I did. So I didn't mind paying half price for this. It's pretty decent.
The rest of these prices were extortionate.
They were. So half price is about right, actually. But anyway, what do we go with?
Oh, fuck, nice.
That's finished. Let's play this anyway.
Look inside your dictionary.
Yes, there we go. Love is a four-letter word from Get Carter.
There you go.
Theme of the week.
Valentine's again.
That's right. But yeah, it is, isn't it? But Malachi Trout's lovely label is putting out the 7 of this.
Really?
Yeah, that's right. He's done a few Roy Budd things recently, and yeah, so. I haven't got any of them yet, and they look so freaking cool. But yeah, I will be. Hopefully, I might just give him a call.
Bell,
I think I might give him a bell and see if I can get some from the man himself.
I'll have one.
Cool. Yeah. No worries.
Oh, that was easy.
Yeah. Yeah, this is great. So there you go.
So yeah, I went to see the Lego Movie 2.
Any good?
So, I like the first one. I like that.
Yeah, yeah.
Alright. Yeah, another movie this week, sorry. Not much to talk about. So, anyway, make sure you check out the Craig Bar Show. Make sure you pick up the Bruton Digging in the Vaults.
And the.
Oh, yeah, and the wonderful jazz album from.
I've lost it already.
It's there. Doran Seagal.
That's it, Doran Seagal. On Village Live. It's wicked. Really,
Village
cool.
Live,
so,
yeah.
There you go. So, yes.
And we will catch you next week.